Typically, when we get a new version of some kind of technology, one of the key selling points is, it's way faster than your old one. And in fairness to Intel, Thunderbolt 4 is 4 times faster than USB 3, except for one small problem. USB 3 is not the previous generation technology for Thunderbolt, and it turned out that Intel was also referring to the version of USB 3 that is 10 gigabit per second, not 20 gigabit. So at 40 gigabit per second, Thunderbolt 4 actually has the exact same transfer speeds as its predecessor, Thunderbolt 3. So then, is there any real reason to get excited? Well, maybe. As it turns out, that 40 gigabit speed was actually a little misleading before. While it was already the maximum overall speed, some Thunderbolt 3 ports only supported speeds of up to 16 gigabits per second for PCI Express devices. That limited the top speed of high-performance devices like external storage solutions and graphics cards. Thunderbolt 4, by contrast, increases this to 32 gigabits per second, with Intel claiming that users could see external SSD speeds of up to 3 gigabytes a second. That could be helpful if you're a video editor loading tons of footage onto your external storage device from a camera, or if you're just someone who moves a lot of files around for fun. And even if you're not constantly shuffling huge amounts of data back and forth, Thunderbolt 4 offers the ability to connect 2 4K displays or 1 8K display. And with all the multitasking we're doing these days, driving multiple high-resolution external monitors with a single compact port on an ultralight notebook could be pretty convenient. Now, some Thunderbolt 3 systems could also handle dual 4K displays, but that wasn't the case across the board, so the summary version is that Thunderbolt 4 has more stringent minimum requirements, making it significantly easier to understand the capabilities of the device that you're buying. Thunderbolt 4 will also enable docks with up to 4 ports, which is double that Thunderbolt 3 supported, and it'll allow input devices like keyboards or mice that are connected via a Thunderbolt 4 dock or port to wake up the system. Surprisingly, this didn't always happen before, even though it's something we've taken for granted over USB for quite some time now. There's also a requirement for lightweight laptops that at least one port to get Thunderbolt 4 certification will enable USB-C charging, so you'll be able to get power delivery on any ultra-portable that supports Thunderbolt 4. And it's also fully compatible with USB 4, which hasn't made deep inroads into the market just yet, but probably will over the next year or two. To top it all off, Intel is promising that Thunderbolt 4 has enhanced security to protect against vulnerabilities like ThunderSpy, which made headlines in mid-2020. And also that the cables should work to up to 2 meters, so you shouldn't need active cables at or below that length. That'll hopefully drive costs down a little bit. As you might expect, Thunderbolt is still an expensive protocol compared to USB though, and it's not exactly easy to tell which devices support Thunderbolt 4. Now, Intel says that all you have to do is look for the Thunderbolt icon, but it isn't always obvious whether the sticker indicates Thunderbolt 4 or an older version of the standard, and they use exactly the same Type-C connector. So you'll want to pay extra close attention to those spec sheets if you're in the market for a PC with a Thunderbolt port. The first computers to offer Thunderbolt 4 are going to be laptops featuring Intel's Tiger Lake 11th gen processors from late 2020, which support the new protocol natively. Hopefully that change helps to make Thunderbolt a more common and, again, more inexpensive standard. But in the meantime, you can always just try to earn some money on the side if 10 gig USB is really too slow for you. I mean, you know, who has an 8K camera anyway? Check out Privacy, the tool that makes it super easy to manage your financial life online while keeping your information secure. By generating virtual numbers, Privacy masks your real bank information so you never have to worry about giving it to people that you don't know. We're encouraged to stay at home during the holiday shopping season, and Privacy makes it easy and safe to shop online, donate to organizations, and support small businesses. So use your Privacy card. You can easily and safely share a card with a friend, family member, or coworker straight from the dashboard in just a few clicks. No screenshots, no copy-paste, and the recipient doesn't even need a Privacy account. You can also control your subscriptions, so you're never accidentally billed twice or upgraded without your consent. Try it out today at privacy.com/techquickie. So thanks for watching, guys. Like, dislike, check out our other videos. Leave a comment if you have a suggestion for a future video, and don't forget to subscribe or you're gonna have a librarian show up at your house and get mad at you for that library book you never returned. I know you did it, Craig.